With hopes of determining the preferences of our target market, the Fabriq team created a short questionnaire, including questions that would alert us to what our target market is really like and what those in it are looking for in an online fashion outlet. The following footage shows some of these interviews that we conducted and how these individuals reacted to Fabriq's business concept.
So, being interested in graphic design has always been not necessarily a dream, but a pretty cool idea to have my work on like t-shirts and just a whole line of clothing in general. So, you know, I strive for that. It would be really cool to have, you know, someone help me, you know, or some organization help me put that together.
Well, you know, my first thought is obviously, I know a couple of kids involved with a small clothing company known as Candy Grind, and they, for example, don't like to get involved with companies that promote other big brands because they don't like that association that they get. They don't like to be associated with Burton and other big snowboarding company brands. They like to stay individual, select, and small, special in particular. But outside of that, you know, especially in this age of kind of hipster chic savvy where everybody's looking for that clothing line that nobody else has, and everybody's looking for that style that nobody else owns, you know, I think that's a great way for people to be able to find those styles, and it's a great way if companies do want to get involved with it for them to market their clothing and for them to get popular and expand a little bit.
Yeah, I agree. I'd say that, you know, it sounds like it's going to be able to unify a community who all wears the same kind of, you know, clothing. And it's going to be really easy just to go to, like, one place and be like, ah, all my homies, like, wear this kind of brand, and all these homies are wearing this kind of brand, this kind of style. You know, it's really easy just to, you know, go to one place and get all that good stuff.
What would you see the benefits of a website like this, and like what would you see as some potential drawbacks?
Well, I think there'd be a lot of benefits in it. The only thing that I'd be weary about is there's just a saturated market for it. There's already customers that already go to Jack Threads and other sites like that. But other than that, I mean, if you did it strategically, then you could really, you know, make some nice deals with the bigger companies, and maybe have them do a type of deal where you could do like something with a bigger company and then a deal with a smaller company too, so maybe they could tie in together and maybe help each other out or something like that.
So if there was a site that exposed smaller brands that you might not be able to find because of geography or another barrier, this would be something that you would be interested in.
Yeah, definitely be something interesting. And a lot of the places that are smaller are more localized in certain states. So if maybe, you know, something's made in Wisconsin and someone in Virginia heard about it and they want to get it, they could get it from your website.
Exactly.
And that would be a great thing as well.
Exactly.
Overall, these customer interviews have provided vital information that we could not have obtained from secondary sources. Through these respondents, we have learned much about our target market. We now know what they think of an e-commerce site like Fabriq. With this knowledge, we can craft Fabriq to cater to these individual tastes.